Good Friday morning. It's time to do a floorboard. I know y'all been waiting on this. It's a coming. Now remember, floors are not attached to the rockers on either side. It's not attached at the back at all, except for these screws. The front is attached all the way across there, but we're removing this. So I think the best and quickest route is to come in here and just cut the inside out. Cut right through the edge wherever I can here, and then take the chisel and chisel that off there, because I don't want to blow a bunch of holes in that. I'll save that for the firewall scan. Once I get that cut off there, it should fall right out. Well, once I take them screws out of the back. Get that out of there. I can do some cleanup work. And I want to go ahead and weld this up. On the inside, of course, both sides, and I can get them ground up and ready to go. So yeah, let's go ahead and get this thing rolled up and see what we can do. That brace there and that brace there. That center area is going to be really tight. So, same way with that bracket. So, what I'm going to do, I'm going to go ahead and cut what I can from this side with the plasma, and then I'll roll it up. I got to unbolt the steering braces from the firewall and figure out where those parts are welded in there. Well, there's some welding up in here to do. Yeah. Okay. All right. I'll let go of my shirt. Let's, I guess, get you set up and we'll start cutting. I think I'm just gonna see how the chisel will do. Save some labor. I'll just come in right here and start working my way around. Then I get that bolt cut off there. It's morning, guys. I picked everything up and it's like, I gotta figure out what I did with everything. Like I say, guys, it's a fit thing, whatever it takes. You know what? I'm gonna rotate that around a little bit farther. It should be loose, other than those bolts and those screws in the back. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put a couple clamps on the back lip, pull them screws out, and then I'll come up here and take these bolts. Actually, I just put the forklift under it. Really? Hold on, I gotta get a different socket. Alright. I thought they were 3/8 bolts. Those will not be going back in. Because he wants that fuel tank mount removed. Alright, looks like I got one bolt from underneath on each side. What's up?
Oh, that's half inch.
I need it in 9/16.
And those are half inch.
Shazam!
Sam!
Come on now.
In the new stuff.
Let's see if it'll drop.
Just a tight squeeze.
I don't see nothing holding it.
Oh, yeah, dude. Got to take back bolts out. See why I waited to weld that? It's right here. I like it. This one I need to do just a touch of trim. Right there.
Putting some clamps on there with a piece of brass on the back side to help keep that as flat as possible. I'll tap that around just a hair. Now these are never perfect because this is always rippled. You can see here where they stamped all this, and this is rippled where they stamped this, but I try to get them as smooth as possible. All right, I'm gonna get this tacked. I can say one thing, for the most part, aftermarket parts have come a long, long way. This panel is double the thickness of this one, so that's a big plus. Used to, this was like garbage. This is thicker. I've noticed in the past 8-10 years, the materials they use is a lot heavier. Now, that's not saying it's the best material, but they do use a lot of recycled junk. up. Gotta get another screwdriver. That one's too thick. And my helmet. Another fun fact. Remember when I said on the back of the cab there's numbers? There they are again. Okay, remember I said I'd take care of that before I put the floors in. I'm gonna show you how I'm going to do that. Okay. I need a piece to go across that. Will I be able to? That ain't gonna work. Come on. Okay, dang it. Come on. Now. Let's try that. Really? Clamp a piece on there to pull that in where it needs to be. like that, and then where did my angle iron go? There it is. Then tack a piece on there. Nope, that ain't gonna work either. Dang you. Okay. Regroup again. Get that pulled in there. I gotta get something. That's going to keep that in line. Okay, now unclamp that. Come on. It's still not going to be perfect, but it's going to be a lot closer. Oh yeah, that's a lot closer. Thank you. All right, I got it lined up this way and back here, but it's still not up all the way, so I'm going to fix that. Perfect. Now, I'm going to go ahead and weld the seam up on the bottom side. Well, look at that. This side went right in place, guys. Thank you. Wow, this side came out real nice. Glad I started on the other side first. Alright, new battery. It's all welded up, looking nice. Now, I ain't concerned with this because they're coming right back out. I need to clean up on this a little bit, get some coatings on that. The rest of it looks good. I might go ahead and grind them up while it's right here, you know. Yeah, I might go ahead and get that. I'm gonna clean this up, grind those, get them sprayed, and then I'm gonna go to lunch.
Thank you.
spray his rust converter up in there because you can't get into all of it. Man, these spray nozzles don't spray all that great. Looks like I got it all. A little heavy, but that's fine. I'd rather have a little heavy up in there. All right, I think I'm gonna go to lunch. I don't know. Of course, I had to fix the cab corners, make them match up a little better too. And yeah, that looks good. A lot better than it did when it come in. All right, I think it's time to get that floor. And see how it fits. The sides, I know generally they are too short in height. I learned last two that I did, I drilled all the holes all the way down the sides and then it was up above the lip on the rocker. So I'm gonna get some measurements on this one before I drill any holes. Because if you can't see, you've only got a half inch right there. Generally, it'll stop right. So I'll get it up in here and see how it fits. I might have to just stitch on the bottom side of that. Back from lunch, guys. Well, I measured these out and it is about eighth to a quarter inch shy of being tall enough, so it's just gonna go in there. My back is not up for this. But it's gotta be, so. Better get some gloves on. Modera.
don't know how they get away with that.
Their holes don't even line up with the parts they welded. Like this inner panel here and the cab support don't even line up on each other. That's the reason I always plug them holes. These ain't so far off, but they're still off. These, that hole, and that hole line up. None of these do. That's why I plug weld all of them. All right, now, as you can see, I'll just pull that over, spot weld all the way down that, because down here it's about right, but it trails. When they stamp this stuff, it shrinks. This side about's the same. So I think I'll get a few clamps on that, get a few tacks on it, and then I'll test fit the firewall.
They did a crappy job lining these holes up. I'm telling you. So much farther today than I am. Come on now, get in there. Just that close. Now, I can't mount the firewall on because I gotta do some work on this lip. It's in pretty sad shape. But I wanna test fit it. These holes line up.
The problem is this panel here, that flange is too wide, so I'm gonna have to trim that back and over on both sides. So that'll work out nice. Clean that up, and then I gotta do some work on this. You can see there's a few issues, but other than that, the firewall will go right on. Awesome. Looks like it fits nice in there. And there. Those holes line up. That's all nice and tight. Well, that works, I guess. Looks like that's gonna be a Monday job. I've got to call somebody to do a water backflow test thingy on the building. The city of Sydney called and said they haven't had a report in 3 years. Okay, I just bought the place. So now I gotta call and have somebody come in and do a backflow water test or something to that nature. I don't know. But I'm gonna have to call around and get somebody in here to do that and turn it into the health department. So that's gonna end the day for me. The only other thing I gotta do, I gotta move some stuff around. I gotta get that car on the hoist because he brought some parts in. A bunch of parts in for tomorrow. So after tomorrow, that car should be a roller again. So I'm gonna get some things moved around, make a couple phone calls. Hopefully it's not too late today. Ooh. I don't have much time. So I'm gonna have to get going. Till the next one, have a blessed evening.